Hello, everyone. Michael Irwin from the Devrel team here at Docker, and I'm excited to talk to you about Docker Build Cloud, our newest product. As we've talked to developers, we've heard a lot about the pain points when it comes to building images. How to optimize, how to make them faster. Why is it that when I build an image, all of my team members have to build the same image and we can't leverage the same caches? Our CI pipelines take forever. It's just like there's so many ways that we can make builds better. And that's what we've really tried to do with Docker Build Cloud. So let me show you in action and we'll see some demos along the way. And hopefully you'll see how builds can be made faster with Docker Build Cloud. I'll start off by opening up the web UI here at build.docker.com. And from here, I can see all the builders that are associated with my organizations. To create a new one, I can just click this button to get started. And within a couple moments, I'll have a builder up and ready. One of the important things to note here is that these builders natively support AMD 64 and ARM 64 architectures. So there's no emulation involved with any of these. As I open up the demo builder here, I can see the CLI commands that are needed to set up my local machine, which will run here in just a second. And then from there, all I had to do is do builds, and then all the builds will be basically passed off to this remote cloud service instead of leveraging the resources on my local machine. Now, jumping into Docker Desktop, I can also do this setup using the new builds tab, and I can see information about the builders, all the recent builds that I've made. But I can also go up to the builder settings up in the top right corner, and I can see that same builder that we saw on the web UI. And clicking on the Connect to Builder button, within just a couple seconds, now this builder has been set up, it's been configured, and it's the default selected builder for me. Now, what that means is when I go to VS Code, I can start using it right away. In this case, what I'm going to do is I'm going to spin up this project, we're going to do some builds, and we're going to see how quick it runs because, I can leverage the caches that are populated by this remote build environment. Just to show that I haven't done any pre-setup or whatnot, you'll see that I've got a clean environment. I've got no images stored locally on my machine. Now, I'm going to spin up this project, and I'm going to just run Docker Compose up. And this particular project, if we take a look at the Compose file, it needs to build a container image, and it's going to build the using the Docker file in the current directory and use the dev stage. If we look at the Docker file, you'll notice that there's not a whole lot that it has to do for the dev environment. We're starting from a node LTS base. We just set the working directory, and then we set the default command that it needs to run. So there's not a lot that it needs to do for this build. But even then, once I do that, all I have to do is download the layers from my remote build environment. Now, if we actually do a full-on build, which I'll do here in just a second, you'll see that it's doing the normal React build. It's going to install my dependencies. It's going to actually do the build. And in this particular case, since we're not doing server-side rendering, I just want to copy out the static HTML, CSS, and JavaScript and serve it with a static web server such as Nginx. So in this case, let's just do a Docker build, sample React app with the current directory. And you'll notice, again, I'm not changing any arguments, or I don't have to change the command at all, but just running this Docker build, now we see that it's going to use the cloud environment and be able to leverage all the cloud resources here. Now, since someone else on my team built this project earlier today, I can leverage the caches that they've populated. Again, I had nothing installed on my machine before, but again, now I can, my builds are much, much faster. And now the image is downloaded, I can spin it up, I can test things out, etc. So now one of the questions is, how does this fit into my CI pipelines? Well, I can either use those buildx commands that we saw in the web UI, or if I'm using GitHub Actions, our buildx action now supports just a little bit of additional configuration to say, I want to use the cloud driver now, and here's the endpoint, here's the builder that I want to use. And you can get this value either through the web UI or in the Docker Desktop UI as well. And with that, once I actually push my code, if we actually take a look at some recent builds that I did, this first one is doing the React build, and I had it doing multi-architecture. And if you've ever done multi-architecture with GitHub Actions, you know that it's doing emulation for the ARM 64. And in this particular React app, it took about 3 minutes to run that build. While once I use Docker Build Cloud, two things happen. One, I'm no longer using emulation. I've got native AMD 64 and ARM 64 support. But then also I'm automatically getting the caches from all the previous builds. And so now my build's only 26 seconds. So again, saving just almost 2.5 minutes every build for a simple application like this. Now, for some of you that may be using Kubernetes in your CI pipelines might be wondering, does this help me at all? Does it or not? And this is actually a pretty common question I get. For those that are in Kubernetes and, you know, seeing the Docker shim being deprecated and removed, it's like, how do I do my builds now? Well, the kind of go-to answer up to this point has been either you have to run a privileged pod and doing Docker in Docker, or you have to run the Docker shim yourself and mount the Docker socket. And so neither of those approaches are really any good. But with Docker Build Cloud now, my pod can just run a Docker CLI, and the build itself will actually happen in the remote build service. So that means that my CI pipeline doesn't need to be privileged, doesn't need any extra permissions or access or anything. And it can leverage this remote build service, populate all the same caches that then my team can take advantage of, et cetera. So hopefully you can see why we're excited about Docker Build Cloud. It just really has the opportunities to speed up builds, help teams be more productive, have these shared cache environments, native multi-architecture support, and more. If you want to get started, just go to build.docker.com and try it out yourself. And as always, we'd love to hear your feedback and know how we can continue to better the product. And with that, thanks and have fun building.